Mark.
Get me upset, man. Read what you got. Who got it? Read
you
that.
Got that?
Read that.
The book of Mark, chapter 4, and verse 15.
Brother, do you know what I'm preaching?
Understand first.
You're going to send an opportunity to reach out and to open up your eyes. You shouldn't be like the oppressor and bump heads. People are talking from their narrative, just like you are, right? So I'm not asking you to read scripture. I'm asking you to common sense. Converse with people. Dialogue.
Do you know what we teaching?
I know exactly what we teaching.
What we teach?
What you believe.
And what is that?
What?
Brother, hold on. I don't think you understand what we're truly out here to do. We go through the scripture. If I wasn't supposed to be upset, you don't think I would have said that? Right?
I think if you wanted to talk to somebody, you would put that microphone out and get their love.
No, give me Isaiah 58 and 1.
Bring it out!
That's not true. See that? You see that? Give me Mark 4 and 15, brother.
Isaiah.
Which one?
And why, let me ask you, why are you upset? I didn't say, I come out here, listen. It's a, hold on, brother. I come out here. Let me ask you a question. How old are you, brother?
Old enough.
All right, and I'm old enough too. We both grown men, right? So I come out here, I don't waste my time. I'm out here to build my women and my brothers, and you telling her, don't waste her time? What is that?
I told you, I said, if you want to get your message across better,
right?
Find a different way to talk to
me. Are you, let me ask you a question. Do you do this?
A lot.
So let me ask you a question. When you do this, what happens? How do you, but what happens when you come out here to preach the word? What happens? These people, the children of Israel, will buck up against you.
That's right.
Have you ever tried speaking softly to people? There's a time when you have to go high, and there's a time when you have to go low. That's right. That's wisdom, brother. Watch this. Give me Ezekiel. Give me Ezekiel.
Yes. Or no?
Yes.
Okay. Then if you know that, right?
Right.
I'm saying, if this woman's
sitting
out here wasting her time.
No, she's not wasting her time.
No, I ain't talking about she's doing something in her life.
Right.
Wasting it, not your, you know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, she's sitting here listening to your narrative and understanding. Why don't you get to a level where it can be received?
I wasn't.
Because at times, brother, sometimes you got to take that microphone down, brother.
Right.
No, I ain't here to harm him.
I got you. No, we good. I got you.
You got her attention.
Right. I was talking to her softly. I don't think you understood why you pulled up. We've been talking and conversing. Brother, you got to let me speak, brother. You, I just let you out the floor. Okay, and I understand that.
All right.
And we've been getting our message across.
I don't know, but I'm saying.
Can I? All right. You said something.
Understand my narrative, and I support.
Brother, I listen to you. Can you listen to me now?
I can't.
Look. They got to get their peace. They got to teach me, and then they got to clear it, man. That's not right, man. Give me Ezekiel 3 and 7, man. Give me Mark 4 and 15. A lot of people come up and they want to say their piece and leave. Like, don't waste your time. Because we're telling our sisters, don't be hoes, right? You mad at that? Because we're telling our brothers, don't kill each other? You mad at that?
Right?
And you want to come say your piece. You want to say what you got to say, but you don't waste your time doing what we do. We come on the street every Saturday, man. More than that. These brothers labor hard in this truth, and you come telling us how to preach the word of God. You don't think we diligently go through these scriptures during the week, man?
Right.
Come on, man. That makes me hot, bro. You know what I'm saying? Scriptures talk about that. What do you do when the children of Israel buck up against you? I'll go through the scriptures and show you. I'm not going off my own logic. The prophets went on the streets. They got upset with the people, man. You think they went out there just talking so, hey, sister, hey, brother, you got to keep the commandments.
Right.
Zacharias got stoned for telling them to keep the laws of God. So what are we to do, man? How much better are we? Right? Come on, man. See, a lot of people, they just want to say what they got to say. Read what you got. Let's go through the scriptures, man. Let's see what they say.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, verse 7.
Right?
Slunk you. But the house of Israel were not hearken unto me.
Right, read.
But they were not hearken unto me.
Right.
For all the house of Israel are impudent.
They are impudent, right? Meaning what? They have iniquity. Read on.
And hard-headed.
And they're what?
Hard-headed.
They're hard-headed. Let's see. Read on.
Behold, I have made my face strong against their faces.
He said, the children of Israel, make your face strong against their faces. Read on.
And thy forehead against strong against their forehead.
So we make our forehead strong against their forehead. Read on.
As an adamant harder than flint have I made thy forehead.
Right, so we got to stand tough just like they stand tough. Read on.
Fear them not.
We don't fear. fear nobody when you come up here, man. Read on.
That's right.
Neither be dismayed at their look. I don't care how you look. I don't care if you got tattoos running all down your damn face, man. We come out and we preach the word of God boldly, right? We preach the word of God boldly. We got the spirit of the Most High with us, man. God already told us what type of people we dealing with. The brother didn't even hear half the conversation, and he came up, well, you ain't got to be upset. Let's see what the Bible say, man. What is the Bible? Give me Mark 1:15. Give me Ecclesiastes 7 and 7, man.
The book of Mark, chapter 4, verse 15.
Right? Read.
And these are they by the wayside.
Right?
Where the word is sown.
The word is what?
Where the word is sown.
The word is sown. It says, these are they by the wayside. Read on.
But when they have heard.
And when they heard me, when all these scriptures come out, what does Satan do?
Satan cometh immediately.
Satan got to come immediately and do what? He got to trick your mind. Read on.
And take away the word.
Don't listen to them, brothers. You wasting your time. What did I say wrong up here so far? I didn't say nothing wrong. I've been in the scriptures the whole time, man. How many scriptures did they give you when they said, we wasting your time?
Right.
Right? Because their preachers ain't, their pastors ain't out here, man. They not out here with the drug dealers, the pimps, the prostitutes. They not out here like that.
They ain't in the field.
Right. Right. You feel me? Say it just like that. They ain't in the field. Exactly. Exactly. When you look at the history of all these prophets and disciples, you think these brothers was just, did you think they was just living in the suburbs and nice neighborhoods? Right? These brothers was true gang, man. Paul was killing up people out here, man. Yeah. Right? When they heard that Jesus got betrayed, what's the first thing they did? They didn't even ask no questions. They cut that brother ear off, man.
They put the stabs on their brother.
Put the stab on him.
Right?
Right? But you want to come up here running your mouth like you know everything. And I try to dialogue with the brother.
And he knew Jesus knew what
was going to betray him. Absolutely. Right? Right? 11 and 7? Come. Let's see what you got, brother. Read what you got.
This is the book Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 7.
Right?
Blame not before thou hast examined the truth.
What did that brother do?
Blame not before thou hast examined the truth.
He blamed us before he heard the truth. Before he examined the truth. And then you got people in the background that want to cheer him on. Get him, brother. Get him, brother. You want to cheer him on? You didn't even hear what we got to say, man.
Right.
You ain't out here building up the children of Israel. You ain't building up your black sisters. You ain't building up your black brothers. The one that kill, the one that murder, the one that steal, right? The one that make your daughters into whores, man. And you mad at us. Come on, man. Get it together. Read.
Understand first and then rebuke.
You got to understand first and then rebuke. Then send that correction, man.
That's right.
What type of men you think you're dealing with? Read on.
Answer not before thou hast heard the cause.
Answer not before you hear the cause. What? It's better that you ask us what we're doing out here first, man. Because you didn't even hear what we got to say. Let me show you why we out here. Give me Luke 4:17. Give me Isaiah 61 and 1. Why are we out here, man? Now, you ain't got to be upset. That's what I want to deal with, right? They act like because you're a man of God, you're not going to get upset when you come out here talking to the people, right? Scriptures already told us these things would happen. I told the brother before we even got on this level, I said, sometimes you got to go low. And I was low the whole time. And I said, sometimes you got to go high. Because when you go low with these people, they're going to come out here and stomp all over you. I'm telling you. Right? That's why pastors can't come out here and do the same thing we do. Because they learned a certain doctrine that tell them to be soft and let a man slap you in your face.
Right.
Right? If you get down on us, we got the spirit on the Lord with us. I'm telling you. You do not want to do that.
Right.
You do not want to do that. Right? We deal with this on the regular. Right? We've had gun AK-47s drawn out on us.
Right.
Machetes drawn out on us.
Right.
People throwing rocks into fireworks. People trying to spit, throw waters and all type of manner of things, man. We've been through this. We've been doing this for years, man. And we're not going back down now. Right? So whoever got that first. Let's see why we're out here, man. You should ask first before you accuse. Ask first before you blame. Right? Get them, brother. You don't even know what we're doing out here, man.
Right.
Read what you got. Whoever got it first, man.
The book of Isaiah chapter 61 and verse 1.
And you should be ashamed of yourself, man. Read.
The spirit of the Most High power is upon me.
Read that again, man.
The spirit of the Most High power is upon
me. The spirit of the Most High power is upon us, the children of Israel. Read on.
Because the Most High hath anointed me to preach good tidings.
Because the Most High has anointed me to preach good tidings, the good news. Read on.
Unto the meek.
Unto the who?
Unto the meek.
That's where we go. We going to the poor neighborhoods, man. We going to the hoods, the sticks, the slums. We preach that good news. What is that good news? Read on.
He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted.
We out here to bind up the brokenhearted. You trying to stop us from doing it. We out here trying to tell these young kings that you are gods in the earth.
Right.
We out here trying to tell you that if you keep the commandments, you can accomplish anything you want to accomplish, man. But you against us. Right? And you don't understand. If you're against us, you're against God. Right? John 18:15. Absolutely. Absolutely. Absolutely, sis. Read.
To proclaim liberty to the captives.
To proclaim what?
Liberty to the captives.
We tell them that you're going to be free, man. We understand you in captivity. We understand you being oppressed, man. Right? You think you got it all figured out. But you're going to continue to destroy yourself in this earth if you continue on your ways, man. Right? Read on.
And the opening of the prison to them that are bound.
And that's what we do. We open the prisons to them that are bound, man. Right? We open the prisons to them. Right? Read what you got.
This is the book of John, chapter 15, verse 18.
There you go.
If the world hates you.
Read that again.
If the world hates you.
Read that again.
If the world hates you.
The world hates these brothers that's preaching the law, statutes, and commandments. Read on.
Right. He know that it hated me before it hated you.
We know you hated God before you hated us, man. Read on.
If ye were of the world, the world will love his own.
If we were of this world, if we loved Biden and Obama, if we loved the government, if we loved the cities, the blocks, the all of these things that we do, we partake in, if we love that, right? Read on.
But because the world will love his own.
The world, you would love us if we did those things, man. You would love us if we said, get along with the white man. Get along with Habib that owns all your gas stations, all your corner stores. Get along with them. Read on.
But because ye are not of the world.
Because we're not of this world, man. You never seen nothing like this before. Read on.
But I have chosen you out of the world.
He chose us out of the world. Read on.
Therefore, the world hateth you.
Therefore, the world gonna hate us, man. We already understand that, man. Right? We already understand that. Right? You gonna hate us. They gonna hate the children of Israel. They gonna hate the ones that, what, stand on the law, statutes, and commandments. Give me Psalms chapter 139 and verse 21. 21, I believe it is. I hate them with a perfect hatred. Right? What does the Bible say? Because a lot of people say, oh, that ain't what the Bible, you're not preaching love. Right? Give me Ecclesiastes 3 and 1.
The book of Psalms, chapter 139, and verse 21.
Right?
Do not I hate them.
Oh, read that again.
Do not I hate them.
Do not I hate them. Read on.
O Most High.
Right, read.
That hate thee.
Don't I hate them. If you hate God, I hate you, man. It's just that simple. If you hate God, I hate you. Read on.
And am not I grieved with those that rise up against thee?
Am I not grieved when I see people rise up against our Heavenly Father, man? We work for the Most High. If you go against my God and my Father, I'm against you. Right? You sure? You sure?
Exodus 15:3.
Oh, we know. We know, brother. We know. Right? Hold what you got. We'll deal with that, sis. Right? We'll deal with that.